outfit that we call the Aboyan, and it comes from an area in Scotland. And it's typically either a tartan, a skirt with a plaid over the shoulder, or a simple white dress with a plaid. And this is an outfit that was worn by women, because up until the last century, women were not permitted to wear the kilt. So they had their own style of dance and their own costume. This dance is called Blue Bonnets Over the Border, and it's performed to that tune by the same name. And it's much more of a balletic dance. It's a woman's dance, so you're going to see a lot more ballet type moves and a much softer style. So this is Wendy performing the Blue Bonnets Over the Border. Also in the Aboyan costume. And again, you may have noticed that that was a little bit more balletic in nature. The shoes that we wear are called gillies, and they're soft shoes. They're very similar to ballet slippers. And a lot of our technique is also very similar to ballet. We have basic footwork, basic positions that is very similar to ballet. We train very similarly. A major difference between ballet and Highland is that we dance up on the balls of our feet. So if you've ever noticed, Highland dancers have very well-developed calves, because we're always up on the balls of our feet, unlike ballet dancers who tend to be more flat or up on point. So again, this is another one of our national dances, again, more balletic in nature, and this is the Scottish lilt performed by we're going to do now. The sword dance, of course. This is a dance I think that really is indelibly associated with Highland dance. Highland dancing was originally, as I mentioned, performed by men wearing a kilt. Much of Highland dance is based in the military. So this dance has its origins in the military. One of the legends has it that they would pick a very nimble-footed soldier who would perform a dance over the swords on the eve of the battle. And if he didn't touch the sword, that was an omen of good luck in the upcoming battle. Another legend has it that King Malcolm Canmore took his sword and placed it over the sword of his vanquished enemy and did a victory dance around it. So, this is a difficult dance to do. We're, as you've noticed, you're spending a lot of time jumping up and down on the balls of our feet, we're pointing our feet, we're turning our knees out, and we also have to contend with a very sharp object on the floor that we do not want to touch for various reasons. One, you don't want to hit the sword because the idea of the dance is not to do so, but also you don't want to hurt yourself. Not that they're that sharp, but dance is simply known to nick their toes on the sword or to trip over them. So things happen, but of course that's not going to happen tonight because Rebecca's going to do a fabulous no pressure. So we have Rebecca doing the sword dance. Meaning they do two slow steps and one fast step. There are different versions of these dances. So anytime you see a Highland dancer clap in the middle of the dance, that's a signal to the piper to speed up the music. So you'll notice that Rebecca was wearing a kilt. So again, kilts were originally only worn by men, but of course women wear them now. And whereas Highland dancing was once a male-dominated sport, it's now very much female-dominated. I should say it is one of the few sports, maybe the only sport, where men and women compete against each other. There is no gender division in this sport, and it is a sport. We treat it as a sport. There is no gender division at all. There are no boys versus, and boys groups and girls groups. It's you dance based on your level and your ability. So if you're a boy or a girl, it doesn't matter. Of course, the boys have the advantage of the strength. The girls have the advantage of the finesse. But it really, a good Highland dancer, a world-class Highland dancer, will have a combination of both the finesse and the strength. And it really is a type of dance that is based more on really finesse and perfection in technique rather than choreography. So we work on the same dances year after year. We have different steps that we can do, but we do have choreography events, but it's mostly you'll see the same repertoire of dances And what we try to do is perfect these dances. So how high can we jump? How well can we turn our knees out? How can we point our feet, our upper bodies? And the reason we dance with our knees turned out is that you ideally want to keep the apron of your kilt flat. So you don't want your knees poking out through the apron of the kilt. So the idea is to have what we call, which every Highland dancer wants, is what we call flat back turnout, meaning that your knees are just back this way. Most people don't have that kind of turnout, so it really is a lifelong sort of struggle to get that kind of turnout, but that's what we aim for. And of course, the ability to dance up on the balls of our feet and to have nice presentation even when we're exhausted. And each dance may only be 2 or 3 minutes, but you are going full out for those 2 or 3 minutes. So I think I've given them enough chance to recap what we have. Okay, they've caught their breath. So as you've noticed, all of the Highland dances to this point were solo dances. And Highland dancing is predominantly a solo dance form. The last dance that we're gonna do for you today is a dance for 4 people. In competition, we are judged individually, but the dance is performed as a group. And this is called a Strathbane Highland Reel. And it's from an area in Scotland, and Strathbane means, it's a type of tune that it is native to Scotland. It's a tune in 4-4. I should say a type of tune in 4-4. You'll notice that dancers are going to clap again in the middle of the dance, and they will go into the reel portion. Reel, R-E-E-L, not reel as a type of dance. So the Strathbane is the slow part, and the reel is the fast part. So if I can have all the girls on, we're gonna do Strathbane and Highland Reel. Tartans with a white background. These are called dress tartans, and basically that means any tartan with a white background is called a dress tartan. And we wear these because we want to stand out more on the stage. So when your footwork around your leg is very tight, and if you're wearing dark socks and you have dark shoes, you can't really see your footwork around the leg. So the idea is to wear something as light and bright as possible so that you're A, noticed on the stage, and B, that we can see your footwork. So I'm just going to have the girls come up one more time just to give you one last bow, and I'll introduce them individually. So at the far end, we have Rebecca. Rebecca. my mom. Thank you. Thank you.